through the closets and attics of the stars with her guest, Baby Jane of Hollywood. Plus, the sensational sounds of the Brian O'Rourke Trio with special guest Jack Sheldon. This is Bill Barr, your announcer. If you need anything, I'll be over here during the show. Just let me know. And now, appearing under some of the biggest hair in show business, Miss Kelly Pappas.
Thank you! Long night. Good. Bye. No. Good to see you tonight. Actually, this is a big hair in show business, Bill. Once in a while, cut to him. Thank you. There's a family of four living in this hair. Yes. God bless you. That'll be bad enough.
Kelly, could you spare some? You
know, yes, absolutely. Okay. Anything after I got
show,
left, right. You got, babe.
Thank you very much.
My hair, short hair. Yeah. I'm so excited. Can we come back to me? Thanks. Hello. Thanks. I just signed a cable deal. I'm so excited. After months of phone calls and toiling, I will get HBO and Showtime at my house. Yeah. God bless you all. This is funny stuff. This stuff you'll pull over later on the 101 and say, my God, I should have laughed. Actually, I'm retaining a lot of water tonight. I've been dieting, and I'm trying to get down to my original weight, 7 pounds 2 ounces, and it is not easy. All right. Billy, we've got a great show for you tonight, and I really want you to sit back and relax. We've got Baby Jane of Hollywood and my special guest, Jack Sheldon. So just stay right where you are, and we'll be right back.
Now, there's an Academy Award right there on your desk.
Yes, well, I can see they're not going to... It's plum. I feel like I escaped from, like, a raisin commercial or whatever. My mother gave me more cord than this. What is this all about?
Allow me.
Hello?
There you go.
Thank you, sweetheart. Bill Barr, your announcer. Yeah. Financial advisor to Donald Trump. Okay, anyway, my guest tonight, Baby Jane of Hollywood. How are you?
Fine, how are you doing?
Nice to see you. These are both Baby Jane. They make up Baby Jane. And Jack Sheldon, how are you tonight?
Very good. This is Baby Jane. I thought this was Siegfried and Roy.
Yeah.
It's Roy.
I'm Roy.
Halfway.
You got the Roy part, right?
Yeah, I got the Roy. They have everything of Hollywood stuff.
Yeah, they've got a great shop. Which camera? Just give me a hint.
You're on.
Wait, what camera am I looking at?
Just go ahead with the show.
I'm
on a tight schedule.
Thank you. Should have took that typing class. Okay, listen. They've got a great shop in the French Market on Santa Monica Boulevard, and I want to thank you for being my guest. They've got memorabilia from everywhere. I mean, they were going to bring Judy Garland's dress from The Wizard of Oz, but what happened? Couldn't get it out of the vault?
I thought the bank closed at four, but it closed at three, and I couldn't get it out of the vault. But the next time, if it can't, it's really good.
I know, I was thinking of wearing it, but I'd have to get some emergency light bulb suction for that. But anyway. Now, I know you brought some very interesting memorabilia. What is this?
Well, this is an actual Academy Award.
What a question. I've been watching this since I was 2 years old. What is this? Okay.
Yeah, this is an Academy Award from 1945, and it was received for Best Art Direction by Hans Dreyer for the film Frenchman's Creek.
Hans Dreyer in the news. Yeah. Nice. This is a real Oscar.
Real Oscar, yes.
You like me. You really like me. Okay, thank you. Yeah. You like me. You really like me. Okay, what else have we got here? We've got some interesting stuff.
Well, Baby Jane got popular for carrying genuine celebrity earthquake ruins.
Yeah, right. You were on CNN, right?
Right.
Now, I think we have a clip from CNN.
Yeah, I think we have the Showbiz Today clip with us.
Yeah, and we'd like to show it right now, if that's at all possible. Do we have that up? And a hush came over her career. Do we have that clip?
The funny thing, because my father, we're talking about Judy Garland's dress.
We got...
So
you've always wanted to start that collection of Hollywood memorabilia, but you just couldn't afford it? Well, ironically, the recent earthquake in Los Angeles may have done you a favor. Mark Bailey reports on how you could own a little piece of history.
A little piece of history. The operative word being little. You see, little pieces are all that's left of these celebrity dishes broken in the January 17th quake. But to some collectors, a genuine Streisand, in any condition, is still a treasure.
Just the idea that I could own something that she once owned, you know, or something that came from her, you know, I'd say that's the main thing.
Now, Tom, you are aware of the fact that this stuff is broken.
yeah, I am, but that's probably the only way that I could afford something of hers.
Treasure hunters are flocking to Baby Jane of Hollywood, happily laying down from $10 to $500 for items that Sinatra probably paid the maid to sweep up. Charles Moniz and Roy Wyndham labored long and hard to assemble this one-of-a-kind collection.
Now, be honest, guys, did you...
And Charles Moniz and Roy Wyndham are here with me today. We've got great stuff. Remember the...
Fickle finger of fate.
From laughing.
This goes out to you, Jay. Okay, anyway. And we've got some stuff. Some Barbra Streisand. What is this, Barbra Streisand's tonsil? What is it?
That's a piece of her wall that from her Beverly Hills home that crumbled during the quake.
What an idea. Who thought of that, to do that? What a great idea. You did, Charles?
Yeah.
Always enterprising. Are you Jewish? Okay, anyway, what's this? Faye Dunaway. Here's the cup she cracked after she sang. Ha! No, sorry.
Oh, Andrew.
Actually, that just missed Andrew Lloyd Webber's head. Yeah.
It just missed
him. The Faye Dunaway quake.
And what is this?
This is Stalker Channing's teapot. She brought this in actually to our store, and she autographed the pieces.
Okay, but she's not that big. Okay, now what is this? What is this?
She was nominated for an Academy Award this year.
She's not a cable, I am.
Those are Shirley Temple shoes. That's what she wore when she was a teenager, and they're size 4.5.
Oh, goodness, really, Shirley?
Shirley
oh,
Temple.
I love it. These are Shirley shoes. I think we have another picture of Shirley right here.
Yeah, that's her wearing the shoes there.
Her and her many dates one night. Yeah. Look at that.
That's a long career there.
And that's from Shirley Temple stars Since You Went Away, and I'll Be Seeing You, becomes the first motion picture actress ever to dance with the servicemen, I doubt that, at the Stage Door Canteen in San Francisco. And, of course, hello, gorgeous. Am I full clemmed or what? She's better than butter. Yes, she is.
Yeah, Barbra Streisand, that's the makeup can from Funny Girl.
And this is the very makeup can right here. Thank you. Gosh, it's quite a makeup can.
Yeah.
How do you keep makeup in there? Isn't that kind of a little inconvenient? Oh, I see. It goes. I thought everything went through here. Okay, hello. What
and we have actually a dress worn by Vivian Vance on I Love Lucy.
Now, that would fit me. That would fit. Oh, no.
No, it's actually.
She was that little?
She was tiny. She was pretty short. And they always played up her as being heavy, but she really wasn't much heavier than the ball.
But they made it.
But that's when she played in the episode, the Chinese Eskimo Indian episode.
Beautiful. And
this is a jacket from Gene Kelly's film debut in Me and My Gal.
Really?
There's a picture of him.
With Judy.
With Judy.
Oh, with Judy. Oh. Yes.
See, look at the buttons are rhinestone dice.
And we also have some original...
Jack, I'll be with you in a minute. Yeah.
We have original artwork used on the cover of TV Guide for Batman, the TV series.
Very nice. Cape Crusader.
Very 60s in the colors.
Very 60s in the colors. Yes, kind of like a sea trend.
Okay, we hope you don't mind us pulling these out of your dressing room. But.
Oh, my God, that's all right. I wear these every night when I watch Tom Snyder.
They're from Harry and the Hendersons.
Yes, they are.
Well, you know what they say about big... What they say about big feet, big hair.
Big hair, big feet. Jack, what do you think of all this stuff?
Well, it's so interesting because, well, it's really so interesting. And I love the stuff. I love the junk, the walls.
The treasures,
yeah, the Hollywood stuff. And it's so ironic because my father was killed in a gay bar in a fight over Judy Garland. Well, it did happen, yeah.
Oh, show tune. Yeah.
This was at the same time my uncle was in Montana breeding sheep. Then all of a sudden he said, these sheep can breed themselves. But it just, those are interesting. It's a great idea, though, getting that stuff, getting the wall. I love
now
that.
Now, I know you've had earthquake ruins, not only from Barbra
Frank Sinatra, James Stewart.
Marlon Brando.
Marlon Brando.
Wow, he does have big china. Look at that. Yes.
And also from Anne Margaret, it's a piece of...
you know, she was so underrated. I loved her.
That's the bow off a Tiffany porcelain box.
It's a ceramic bow off a Tiffany porcelain box. A Tiffany porcelain? Anne Margaret has a Tiffany porcelain box?
Not anymore.
I love that. I would have been nicer to her had I known.
Jackie, did you work with Anne?
I did Anne Margaret's first record that she ever did.
Is that right? What songs were
it? No, it was just 3 hours at the Ramada Inn.
I'm sorry.
Oh, this is a shot from Harry and the Hendersons.
With the shoes. You all know that one.
The feet.
Yeah, the feet. Now, you had something, you know, Jack Sheldon, of course, had a series called Run, Buddy, Run. And what Run do you Buddy? Have from that series?
In the store, we have a comic book of Run, Buddy, Run. It has little cartoon characters of Jack.
That is so great. Where is your store?
It's in the French Market on Santa Monica Boulevard in West Hollywood.
I didn't even know they had a French Market. And is there a lot of French people there?
Everybody Where becomes French when you
come there. Let me warn you, don't say anything bad about Judy Garland there.
Yes, they'll teach you a whole new meaning.
Oh, I know what happened to my father already.
Just hum a lot of show tunes. It'll be safe.
Yeah,
it'll be very safe.
I can't mention anything bad about Judy. Well, it's the French Market. And what is it? Why do they? I don't even want to know.
Well, it hasn't. They have it started looking like a little New Orleans.
Yeah, it's a New Orleans feel. They've got a restaurant in the middle, and surrounding that are all shops, and it's indoors. It's quite lovely. Great food. I hate to say it, but they do have great food over there. They do, yes. So how long have you guys been doing this? Was this always a childhood passion of yours?
Oh, yeah. I've always loved old movies, and I've been collecting since I was 12 years old, buying material and going to flea markets and yard sales, garage sales.
Gosh, he's schwitzing. Do we have a tissue for him?
Schwitzing right on stage.
How about a hand for Miss Gillespie, our makeup girl? Yes.
Great. Thank you.
You're dewy, as they
Thank
say.
You.
You're dewy.
Well, by the end of the show, we're going to see who has the bigger hair, me or you.
Yeah, how's my hair holding up? I get more of a hand for my hair than anything else. Jeff, where are you working now?
Did you have any earthquake damage to your
I
hair?
I did, and I sold it. It's in here. Excellent.
That
excellent.
Is so great. You
Jack,
look
where
so
are you
good.
Working now?
I'm working, I'm working, I'm going to try to get a job at the French Market.
Yeah. I'm right behind you there. Oh, I shouldn't say that. Okay, but I'm with you there. Okay, you these are jokes. They're funny, but I'm ahead of my time. Anyway.
No, I'm working at the Moonlight Tank. Well, when is this show going to be on? Is this show going to be on?
The rest of the millennium, I think.
I mean, but when, do you know a date that this will be shown? Or this?
I think soon. In the
they
next
show
week.
This all the time.
In the next week.
In the next week.
Or two.
All right, I'm working August 14th at the Burbank Starlight Bowl, which is like a...
Oh, I saw you there. What a great place.
Oh, right.
I saw you there a couple years ago.
It's Brian O'Rourke's father. You want to say the Brian?
Can we get a shot of Brian O'Rourke's father, by the way?
Wait a minute, people are eating.
I guess we can't.
No,
we don't have that type of technology yet.
Yeah, well, it's all right, but he's a very good-looking guy.
Yes, he is.
Real slick black hair, little mustache, and. Tuxedo. He always
kind of a Pepe Le Pew.
Brian is that way too, though. Brian is always well dressed. Now you and Brian are an item, aren't you? Are you Brian? Are you? Do you
and this is the Oscar from what year?
Oh, you don't like your.
No, I don't like.
Because to. You love Tom Schneider.
I love Tom Schneider. Yeah.
Why? He is such a jerk.
Oh no!
I hate Tom Schneider. He interviews people and he won't let them talk. He keeps talking. He asks him questions and he never lets anybody answer. He is the jerk of all jerks.
I'm going into my bulimic behavior right now. Yeah.
I like the way you hold the Oscar, though.
Thank you. Yeah. Clutching your life. It's every man for himself on this show.
You want to be nice to Tom Schneider, though. You want to.
You know, it's not I want to be nice. He's so kind and sweet. Why is that not wonderful? That's what's missing.
Well, how, if he was kind and sweet, why wouldn't he let somebody else talk on his
show? I think he does. I think he brings out the best in people.
No, he never lets anybody talk. He asks him a question. Like, I'll be Tom Schneider. So how long have you had your shop? And do you like the shop? A shop like yours could be good down in the French Market. There. And it's, Sorry, we got to go away now for a commercial.
I'm glad I did the end of the show first.
Oh, I like him. I guess.
Okay, so you're at the Moonlight Tango. What dates, Jack?
The 8th. I think Tom Schneider's going to sing with
you. All right. Yeah, he's going to sit in. Yeah.
He's a good singer, and I like Tom. Tom has been through a lot. I shouldn't be so mean to him. I just think that if you're interviewing somebody, you ought to see what they have to say, though.
I think he's a lot of style and a lot of grace, and he has been through a lot, as you say, and he's still graceful.
And his hair,
great.
Too.
It's dignity.
His hair, the way he combs his hair.
All right, so his hair's a little swirly, all right?
When the wind blows, it looks like a suitcase opening. No, he's all right. He's a good guy. Personally, I don't want to be on your show, Tom. I don't even want to see you anyway.
Don't worry, you won't.
Unless it's the French Market down on Santa Monica. Wearing a simple gown and some pearls.
Hello. So where do you guys want to go from here? I mean, you've got the Shirley shoe. Are you going to have like her body when she's embalmed? I mean, how far are you going? You go with the memorabilia. Could you just go for anything you can get?
You have everything. Yeah,
yeah, anything movie star related, we pick up and have in the store. We have.
Now, we're just waiting for a wall to fall down.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. In recent months, of course, Barbara Streisand's been everywhere, all over the news. This concert was huge success, although I was a little, taken with the amount that she charged for tickets. I thought that was just through the roof. Did you have people coming to your store? I know when she canceled, people came into the shop and were just on Prozac, because they were just broken up over this.
Well, we had a lot of people that came in from out of town.
Yeah.
And
spent their life savings.
Yeah, they made a whole trip out of it, a whole vacation here in California. And then when they went to the concert, not even realizing she canceled, they came in with really sad faces and came to our store, though, and spent some money, which was really
perfect.
Got a lot
for
of
you.
Barbara Billion.
And we do have a Barbara Streisand mannequin in our store, so they all posed by her. And
excuse me, Barbara Billion?
Barbara Billion.
Is that what you said? That's cute.
She put out a pretty good line of stuff herself.
Yeah, she did. She had mugs and white shirts and
boxer shorts, ties, scarves.
And I think it's good she charged a lot. That shows that, you get the money. They charge Pavarotti and Placido, and Carreras charge $1,045.
Per ticket?
Yeah. And you get a massage with that, too.
I mean, anyone else that you liked, you would have probably seen like every other year for the last 30 years, right?
This is the big justification.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you've heard Barbara sing for the last 20 years, a dollar a year, that just doesn't work out. I mean, people are working hard. It's a recession. We just had an earthquake. For California residents, I think she should have really had pity on their souls. I don't know. She's the best, and she's totally worth it. But, $300.
Well, now she's coming to cable.
Now she's coming. She'll be on the show next week. And, in my drink.
I'm going to go to her next concert.
I think the concerts are over, Jack.
Oh, they are now?
Yeah.
I missed the whole thing?
You missed the whole thing.
I had her right on a list, too. It was right after Learn Spanish.
Okay, we didn't get the dates from the Moonlight Tango. When are you there?
The Moonlight Tango, August 8th or 9th.
Whichever day, you want to mosey over.
And Tom Schneider will be singing with the band. I'm just kidding about Tom. He's really a jerk.
Would you give a hand to all my guests? Thank you, Jack. Thank you, Charles. Thank you, Roy. We want to thank you all for being here. We hope we'll see you next time on Curtain Call. There'll be a number at the end of the show if you want to call and leave a dirty message on my machine. I don't care. I need the contact. Okay? So, good night. God bless. And Tom, I love you. Good night, everybody.
Buy you a diamond ring, my friend, if it makes you feel alright. you feel all right. I don't care too much for money. Money can't buy me love. Now I'll give you all I got to give. If you say you love me too. I may not have a lot to give, but what I got, I'll give to you. Well, I don't care too much for money. Money can't buy me love. It can't buy me love.
Sheldon for a whole song. Here's Just in Time. You can clap.
Thank you.
Just in time. I found you just in time.
Yeah.
Before you came, my time was running low. I was lost. The losing dice were tossed. My bridges all were crossed. Nowhere to go. Now you're here. And now I know just where I'm going. No more doubt or fear. I found my way. 'Cause love came just in time. I found you just in time. Changed my lonely life that lovely day.
Yeah. Just in time, I found you just in time. Before you came, all my time was running low. You know that I was lost. The losing dice were tossed. My bridges all crossed. Nowhere to go.
Just in time.
Just in time.
You changed my lonely life that lovely day.
Yeah, you changed my lonely life.
thank all my guests, Mr. Jack Sheldon, Charles Maniz, Roy Windham. I'll see you on the radio, sweetie. We do a radio show every day. Thank you for my Oscar. I want to thank the Academy for this award. And right now, my announcer, Mr. Bill Barr.
That's right. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You should get an Oscar for this song that you finished the show with, a Irving Berlin standard that we all know and love, the Brian O'Rourke Trio, Jack Sheldon, and now Miss Kelly Pappas. What'll I do?
Thank you. You know, this show is dedicated to Tom Snyder. I love you, Tom. I love you so much. Now, I went by CNBC and they gave me a picture of Tom. Great team, don't you think? It's fabulous. Tom, I noticed on your show you've got a player piano playing with nobody playing it. Perhaps it's Hollywood, but I really want to be on your show singing with my wonderful accompanist. I think we'd do you well. And I love you, and I live across the street, so it wouldn't be much of a commute. Anyway, Tom, this goes out to you.
What'll I do when you are far away and I am blue? What'll I do? What'll I do?
When I'm alone. Seven, six, two, one.